Hi, we're here today for the celebration of the 4th of July, July 3rd, 1999, and we're doing a survey on what people think their definition of a hero is and what they think about Ulysses and Julia Grant in our American hero status. Perspective on what he believes is heroic about Ulysses S. Grant and his wife Julia Dent Grant. John?
Thank you, Lisa. Ulysses S. Grant really impresses me as someone who is able to cope with whatever life dealt him. In that regard, he's a lot like Harry Truman. Never say die. Always, always give it your very best. Grant was the kind of person that rolled up his sleeves and just got the job done. And one of the unique things about this site is that you see a whole different picture of Ulysses S. Grant. Here you see Grant as husband and father. The history books celebrate him as the great military leader and as a political figure, as president. But here you see Grant as I think he would like to be remembered, as a husband and a father. Certainly if you look at his life, especially at the end of his life, when it would have been very easy for him to give in to his illness and just sink into despair, he never did that. The effort of writing his memoirs when he was obviously in great pain and discomfort again points out the fact that here is someone who gave it everything he could and always, always remained attuned to what he was about. He was always ready to pitch in, roll up his sleeves, and never, ever say, I give up. A lot of things that we can learn from Grant. Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you, John, and I'm sure we both agree that in this day and age that it is nice to have an American hero to look up to in our history.
It certainly is. It certainly is.
Thank you. This time with Acting Superintendent Bob Moore. He's been with us for most of the summer, and he has had a history with our site from its beginning. So we're very interested to see what he's got to say about Grant and Julia as American heroes.
And as usual, I'm getting on camera again. I'm always on camera, it seems. And you want to know what makes them heroic in my mind.
Yeah. In your definition of heroic or hero.
I think that both Grant and Julia, when they lived out here, were pretty ordinary folks, you know? I mean, you wouldn't expect that anything extraordinary would happen to them during their lives. They, you know, were really struggling to make a living in the 1850s, and probably Grant even felt that he was a failure. He'd tried the Army and felt that that life just wasn't for him because he couldn't be with his family. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it seems like heroism might come in and just saying, maybe I'm not going to reach for that brass ring, maybe I'm not going to try to be, you know, Mr. X, Y, and Z, but I'm going to try to be a good husband and father and be with my family. And he made that choice, and then things weren't working out so well when he lived here in St. Louis. But when the time came, when the call came, when the war began, he had special talents, specific things that he could do that could help the entire nation, things that when he lived here probably he didn't even realize, but that came forth when the call came. So, you know, maybe the heroism came in being able to survive through the tough times, to be that ordinary person, the ordinary Joe, and then when the call came, you know, go out there and do something spectacular.
All right. Very good insight. We thank you for your thoughts, and we'll see you
for
in
what
a minute.
It's worth.
Visit Whitehaven. Back again, this time at the Grant Camp of the Sons of Union Veterans. We'd like to get their insight on what they believe from their perspective of what Ulysses S. Grant and Julia Grant had as far as characteristics of heroism. So let's talk to them.
Hi, Lisa.
Hi, how are you? We have Steve Light. He's the commander of the Grant Camp, Sons of Union Veterans. And he's been pondering on this question for a while, so let's see what he has to say.
Hi.
What are your thoughts about Ulysses S. Grant and Julia Grant in their status in our American history as heroes?
As a hero for during the Civil War, and I like to think of all the men who fought for the Union Army as heroes because of their courage to join the Army, to stand up, to hold the United States together as one union. As for the women that helped in the homesteads as the men went off to fight the war, in their own rights they are heroes also because they had to take care of the children and the homestead while the men were gone. As for Ulysses S. Grant's purpose in history, he has served his country well as a general of the United States Army, and knowing the what was necessary to bring the war to an end so that this country could get back as one.
Wonderful. Thank you for that perspective. And we have two other gentlemen. Do you have any insight on Ulysses S. Grant, or maybe just a hero in general?
I think he had to make some very hard decisions, and he made them. And they weren't always the best decisions, but somebody has to make them when it comes to war.
And Grant made that call. How about you?
He persevered through the hard times to keep going forward, even when it was hard to go forward.
Would you all have liked to fight under him? Fought under him?
I don't know if I'd say that or not.
Well, we appreciate you being here today, and thank you for your insight. Again, in front of the visitor center, the historic barn of Ulysses S. Grant's farm during his presidency. And I'm standing here with Lorraine Eckerd, wife of our chief of interpretation, but also, more importantly, a volunteer here at the site. And I'd like to ask you, Lorraine, what your perspective is on the word hero.
I think a hero is someone who is willing to give the ultimate for a cause or someone else, even their life. I think a hero sees other people's needs in front of their own on a larger scale or a smaller scale.
Wonderful. What do you think about Ulysses S. Grant and possibly Julia Grant in her relationship to his life? How do you think they fit into that spectrum in our American history?
Well, from what I know about the couple, I believe their relationship to each other was more of a 20th century type of relationship. He respected her opinion, he adored her, and in return she gave him good advice, and they were just a really good pair, a good team. And from that point in time, relationships like that weren't common. Mm-hmm. You know, it was the man who kind of had his way of doing things, and that was that. Mm-hmm. But theirs was more of a team, and I think that I think that reflected very well in their relationship.
And they sacrificed for each other, and they were able to give it back to one another and also to their children. So thank you very much for that wonderful, insightful interview.
All right.
Thank you. Hello. We have the...
Hi, Lisa. How are you?
Hi, I'm fine. How are you?
Pretty good.
Does anyone in this car have a perspective on Grant as our American hero? Do you want to say anything about what your feelings are on Grant, or maybe a hero in general?
Well, he saved the Union.
He sure did.
That's the biggest thing.
All right. And we're proud to have that Grant name here, so.
Oh, yes, indeed.
Great.
Well, the whole area is General Grant. Everything here is General Grant.
Right.
All the streets are named after General, or one of the area of the Civil War. And mm-hmm. Even we've named the City Hall Street Missionary Ridge, which was one of the
big battles.
Last big battle.
Well, we're glad that we're commemorating his American heroism in our history, so thank you. We're back again, and I'm standing here with three students from the St. Ambrose School who in the past few months have been working on a Civil War museum. Of course, they're on summer vacation, but they've devoted their time to come to us today to display their projects and to give some history. But in their studies, I was interested in finding out how much they learned and what kind of perspective they had about Ulysses S. Grant and being a hero. But first, I want to know what their thoughts are on the hero itself, on what a hero is. What do you think a hero is?
Claire Hoff.
Okay, Claire.
I think a hero is someone you can look up to and is brave and stands up for their country or what they think is right, even if they're standing alone.
Very good. Okay. Well, I'll hold that thought. Now, what do you think about a hero?
A hero is somebody who has, like, very good qualities, and like Claire, somebody who stands up even if there's nobody else to help them. Mm-hmm. They stand up no matter what comes against them.
Do you have a hero in your life?
I'd have to think about that.
What about you, Claire? Do you have a hero in your life?
I'd have to think about that, too.
Okay, well, we'll get back to you on that. What's your name? I'm sorry, what was your name?
Rob Ballins.
Okay, and your name?
Matt McKeever.
Okay, Matt, what do you think?
I think a hero is somebody who is brave and doesn't give up, mm-hmm. and they stand up for people, and they, and
someone to look
up
to.
Yeah, someone to look up to, and when something bad happens, you know that hero is probably going to come and
mm-hmm. and take care of things,
yeah.
right? And answer the call of duty. Anyone in your life you think of that's a hero?
I have two. Probably okay. my parents.
Your parents, because
yeah.
they take care of things, right? They answer the call of duty, and they take care of it. Someone to look up to.
Yeah.
What about you, Rob?
I'm with him. I think my parents, and then on my Civil War project, I think I kind of look up to Elijah Lovejoy because he wrote his feelings, even though people attacked him numbers of times.
Mm-hmm.
He stood alone except for a small number of people, and no matter what the odds were, he stood up for what mm-hmm. he thought was right.
And he also left behind an account for people today to research him. So that's also important because we can learn about that era through personal artifacts and letters.
Great, thank you.
What about Claire?
I'd have to say my parents and my grandparents also, and the people during the Civil War that helped the slaves escape because having slavery was wrong.
Exactly, and that was also putting their life on the line for the cause of people who could not stand up for themselves.
Right?
Right. Okay. Well, that is a great start, but I want to know now about Ulysses S. Grant and maybe Julia Grant. What did you learn about Grant, and how does he fit into your perspective of a hero?
Well, he stands up for his country and what is right because he fought in the Civil War, and he mm-hmm. led the U.S. Army. And Julia, she had to, even though she wasn't physically with him at the time, she had to go through this with him, not having her husband at home, and he was risking his life. She was just, you know, very...
She was behind the scenes,
yeah.
but she was able to make that stable
yeah.
environment for his home. That's good. Great, like a good wife did at that time.
What I think of Grant is I think he was a good person because he didn't like slavery.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a Civil War general who later became the president.
Right.
So you'd have to think he'd have to be pretty good to do that.
Exactly. And
you can't just be an everyday person and become the president.
Exactly. And also he had the American people behind him, and they must have thought of him as an American hero if they looked toward him to bring us through Reconstruction, through a presidency.
I'm sure they did.
Thank you. Okay, Matt, what about Grant?
I think Grant is a hero because he was brave. He never really gave up, and he didn't give up until he had victory over the Confederates.
Mm-hmm.
And he is somebody to look up to because not a normal, usually a normal person can't really just help half of the country beat another half of the country.
Yeah, it's a different time period too, and in today's terms, you don't find that many heroes that stand up like that, like he did.
And, I mean, like he said, I mean, he became a president, and that's a pretty big thing.
That's saying something, isn't it?
Yeah.
Great.
He was a general and a president, and if you're both, then that means you're pretty special.
Great. Well, thank you. Did you all enjoy working on your projects? Did you learn a lot more than you expected to learn?
Pretty much.
Yeah, way more.
Yeah,
the only part I didn't like was the typing.
Died. Well, you did a very good job, and you have a very great perspective early on, and I look forward to your future because you have it down right now. You're really making a good start. So I appreciate you all coming out and volunteering your time. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Hi, it's Park Ranger Lisa Conard again. It is now 1:50 in the afternoon, and we've been conducting surveys all day on what a hero is and how Ulysses S. Grant and Julia Dent Grant fit into that category. I'm here with one of our astute volunteers. Is that a good word?
Oh, that's good.
And he has a great perspective on the subject. Ed Moeller, what is a hero?
Opportunity. You can't be a hero unless the opportunity comes. And Grant was a hero because he rose to the opportunity. He was the common man, the quiet man, but he was the man that got the job done.
And how does Julia fit into that picture with him? Could she be a heroine?
Well, of course she's a heroine. She's the strong woman in the background behind the man in the limelight.
Behind every good man is a great woman.
Yes.
Good man, great woman.
Or the other way around.
Anything else you'd like to add about Grant's heroic characteristics?
No, I just always have thought he was a hero from the idea that he was the quiet man who went out and got the job done. He wasn't one of these boisterous ones that went out, beat themselves on the chest and say, I'm going to do this, or I'm going to do that. He just went out and got the job done.
Very good. Thank you so much, Ed. Hello. How are you?
Fine.
We are emphasizing, of course, the 4th of July weekend, but we're also emphasizing Grant's role as our American hero. So I was wondering if you had any thoughts about what a hero is and what makes Ulysses S. Grant and possibly Julia fit into those characteristics.
Mark, you're good at answering questions.
Yeah, but you answer first.
No, I don't.
What do you think a hero is?
Hero, someone we all look up to.
Okay.
Someone who did something brave and courageous for our country.
All right. How about you?
He wrote his life story when he had throat cancer.
That was a hero.
So Grant, through his perseverance at the end of his life?
Mm-hmm. Provided for his family.
Okay. So with your characteristics of a hero, how does Grant fit in your mind?
Well, he was a great general in the Union forces.
Uh-huh.
Name one of his battles.
One of his battles in the Civil War was one of his battles, several of his battles.
Like Shiloh or Vicksburg,
yes,
and there's so
yes,
many.
One of the
Chattanooga
Harbor.
Or Cold Harbor.
Chattanooga or something, yeah.
What about Julia? How in that period do you think that women could have served as heroes?
She kept him, supported him through her letters. And
didn't they make mm-hmm. uniforms too?
Some women did.
Mm-hmm. That I would think through the letters that was enough, you know, support. And I guess she visited him once in a while, I'm not
right.
sure.
Right, she did. She kind of kept that
history.
Stable environment possible,
yeah.
taking maybe one of the children with him or with her to see him.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. What do you think? You all know anything about Ulysses S. Grant? Have you studied him? And what did the American people do after the end of the Civil War, after he was victorious? What did the American people do to repay him?
Make him president.
Say it again.
Make him president.
They elected him president. You think that's repaying him? Grant had a tough time, but that's right. He was elected to two terms as our nation's 18th president. So
18th president. That's what we were just yeah. talking about, what number he was.
Yeah. Y'all should stick around for our trivia because you could win some neat prizes.
We can do a little more.
We're picking teams in about 20 minutes.
Okay.
So thank you very much.
Thank you.